The cycle of violence between man and machine is one of the main themes that drives the 2004 reimagined Battlestar Galactica series. However, this cyclical conflict wasn't always solely between humans and Cylons. Within the machine race itself, war has erupted more than once. In this video, I'd like to discuss the Cylon Civil War, what caused it, and how it contributes to the central theme of perpetual violence. The setting for the Cylons' internal conflict begins after the fierce reignition of the war between the humans of the 12 colonies and the Cylons they created. After disappearing more than 40 years prior when an armistice was reached, the Cylons returned to exact their revenge on the humans that had once enslaved them. They launched a devastating attack on the planets of the 12 colonies with the goal of exterminating humanity. A small number of humans survived, the Battlestar Galactica, a recently decommissioned colonial warship, and a ragtag civilian fleet fled into space, seeking a new life, a new home, all the while being pursued relentlessly by the Cylons seeking to finish what they started. During the Cylons' lengthy absence, significant upgrades were made to their arsenal and their machine forms, as well as the creation of 7 new lines of flesh and blood humanoid models. These models mimicked the human form in virtually every way with a few differences, the most notable being their inability to reproduce as humans do. With the use of resurrection technology, however, humanoid Cylons ensured that they could essentially live forever. When one is destroyed, their consciousness is automatically downloaded to a new body within its same line. Along with this leap in technological advancement came dramatic changes within the Cylon hierarchy. During the First Cylon War, the Centurion models possessed full artificial sentience and served in leadership roles. However, after the creation of the humanoid Cylons, a new model of Centurion was created, one that was completely subservient to their flesh and blood brethren. Though they were created with the capacity for full artificial sentience and independent action, the more advanced humanoid Cylons, recognizing the potential for an uprising within their own ranks, implanted inhibitor devices in them to prevent higher intelligence and to ensure that their machine soldiers could not cause them any harm. As the humanoid Cylons sought advancement and their own continued survival, they were in fact laying the foundation for a new rebellion. They recognized what higher intelligence can lead to in the Centurions, yet they failed to see this potential within themselves. The first signs of the impending Cylon Civil War began on New Caprica, when the Cylons occupied the humans' resettlement. During the highly volatile occupation, the different humanoid models began to argue over their dealings with the humans. Two factions began to develop within the hierarchy. One that was religiously motivated, thinking the slaughter of mankind had been a mistake, and genuinely wanted to work towards a peaceful future with humans. And the other, led by the atheistic number one model, who saw humans as lesser beings, taking a militant approach in his response to the colony's increasing violence towards them. This dissent within the ranks also began to manifest within the single model lines themselves. The individual copies within a single line typically agreed with each other, as they all shared the same core personality type. However, an individual Model 6 began to disagree with the strong measures being taken to control the human population of New Caprica. The intense hostility between humans and Cylons contributed to increasing tension among the humanoid models, erupting in a rare incident of violence between them. Another point of division began taking shape at this time when it became the religious quest of the Model 3s to find their hidden Cylon ancestors, known as the Final Five. This endeavor was in direct conflict with the combative Number 1 model, whose hidden agenda hinged on their remaining a secret. As she remained unshaken from her pursuit, the Number 1s had her entire model line boxed, with her individual model's consciousness kept in cold storage in an inactive state. To fully understand the motives behind Number 1's divisive actions, we must consider the Cylons' ancestors. Long ago, highly advanced Cylons separated from their human creators after a long and bloody war where they went on to create their own civilization. The Cylons had evolved to fully mimic their human creators. They were flesh and blood, and eventually were able to naturally reproduce. Generations later, naturally born Cylons eventually repeated the same mistakes of their ancient enemies, creating sentient robots to serve them. After the inevitable war that followed, Cylon civilization destroyed itself in a nuclear war, with only 5 humanoid Cylons managing to survive the apocalypse. These beings, known as the Final 5, made it their aim to find the 12 tribes of man to warn them against repeating their mistakes. Their journey was lengthy, and by the time they arrived to the populated worlds of the 12 colonies, it was too late. Their war was already well underway. Subsequently, the 5 reached out to their less advanced brethren from the colonies, offering their knowledge and assistance in reaching the next stage in their evolution, if they agreed to end hostilities with the humans. The number one model was the first to be created, and even assisted in the development of the other 6. However, the ones gradually grew discontented with their human characteristics, coming to view them with contempt, and resenting the 5's appreciation of the humans of the 12 colonies. He later enacted the plan to reignite the war, exacting his revenge upon the humans that had once enslaved their kind, while simultaneously teaching the 5 a lesson regarding the failings of human nature. He did this by placing them among colonial society with no knowledge of their true identity. The number ones had also adjusted the memories of the other humanoid Cylons so that the identities of the 5 would be unknown to them, even though they were still aware of their existence. As the number one's plan started to unravel, he began to resort to more extreme measures in order to keep his schemes a secret from the others, further adding to the division between them. After the exodus from New Caprica, the diverging ideologies within Cylon society reached a critical stage, culminating in an all-out war between the 2 factions. The event that spearheaded this internal rebellion occurred after the arrival of the colonial fleet to the mysterious Ionian Nebula, upon which 4 of the 5 ancient Cylon models who lived among the human survivors were awakened to their true nature. A massive Cylon battalion pursued the vulnerable colonial fleet and launched an overwhelming strike force. However, during the battle in which the humans were hopelessly outmatched, a raider detected the Viper pilot and Cylon, Samuel Anders. Subsequently, all raiders refused to carry on the attack and returned to their base ships, which then jumped away. Not being able to rely on the Cylon raiders to continue attacking the colonial fleet, the Cylon faction, led by Cavil's number one model, made the shocking proposal to reconfigure the raiders' neural architecture to dumb them down, or more accurately, lobotomize them. His reasoning was that they were simple machines programmed for a single purpose. While the raiders had a lower level of intelligence than the Centurion and humanoid models, akin to that of a trained animal, they were sentient and capable of independent thought and action. The other Cylon faction, led by a number 6 model, known as Natalie, vehemently disagreed with this barbaric measure and believed that their goal should be their unification with the unidentified Cylons. This further angered the number 1 model, Cavil, as he was beginning to lose control. The others were configured not even to think about the Final 5, now they were openly discussing them. To enact any significant change in the raiders required a majority vote, and since the Model 3s were boxed, the vote was initially split 3-3. With Models 4 and 5 voting with number 1, and the Models 2, 6, and 8 voting against. Another unprecedented incident occurred when the swing vote was cast by a single Model 8, whose experiences made her highly individualized from her line. While disagreements among the copies of a single model at this point weren't as uncommon, going completely against one's model is likened to a departure from its very identity. This single Model 8 no longer believed coexistence with humans was possible and voted with Cavil, reasoning that this was necessary for them to be able to defend themselves. The lobotomizing of the raiders was the last straw between the 2 contentious factions. As a result, the Natalie 6 model proceeded to remove the inhibitor devices from the Centurions, giving them full sentience and free will. When the Centurions learned what was happening to the raiders, they violently turned against Cavil's faction, And with that, all-out war erupted among the Cylons, with the factions separating among the fleet. Cavil's fleet, however, controlled the resurrection technology, an advantage he used to ensure that the rebel Cylons truly met their end when attacking them. After the rebels suffered heavy losses, they sought to make an alliance with the humans of the colonial fleet. Through this fragile alliance, the colonial forces and rebel Cylons worked together to unbox the Model 3s and destroy the Cylons' resurrection hub. In a final strike to save the first human-Cylon hybrid offspring, a volunteer coalition of allied forces assaulted the Cylon home base called the Colony. The destruction of the Colony brought an end to the Cylon Civil War, as the faction of militant Cylons were wiped out. Despite the risk that they might someday return and attack humanity, the Centurion models who remained after the war were given command of a rebel base star and were set free, with the consensus being that they had earned such freedom. The rebel Cylons, along with the surviving members of the Final Five, would then go on to settle a newly discovered Earth, starting over and fully integrating into human civilization. While the central conflict in this story is between man and machine, it becomes clear that the heart of the issue is the cycle of violence stemming from advanced societies subjugating those they deem to be lesser. At the end of the series, Messenger 6 postulates that due to the law of averages, when a complex system is allowed to repeat itself for long enough, eventually something surprising might occur. So as humans and Cylons embark on a new journey together, the question remains, will all this happen again? But I'm curious to know, what do you think of the Cylon Civil War? Are there any players or particular moments in this conflict that stand out to you? What themes or lessons do you think this event emphasized? Let me know your thoughts in the comments section below. I hope you enjoyed this video. Leave a like if you did, and be sure to subscribe for more Battlestar Galactica and other sci-fi and fantasy news and lore. Thank you all so much for your support, and as always, have a very nerdy day.